I'm a rapper. I'm a rapper. I'll speak on shit.
I hear you.
There you go.
I hear you.
Gang shit.
Yeah, I hear that. So.
Welcome back to the greatest show on planet Earth, Gasworks, ladies and gentlemen. Give us a round of applause, please. Please. A year and a half deep in the game, still out here, still active. NFTR, nowhere to be seen.
Fam, low it.
Who else is nowhere to be seen? Why do I keep getting messages, fam, and emails and risk assessment? Bollocks. People, Paul, what are you saying, fam? Women's World Cup is over, we can finally breathe. Nah, okay, I'll stop. That was the last episode.
Julia, do you know what it is? I can't say nothing to you because you actually helped me through that, so, like, go on.
It's all right, man. We're really hungry, by the way. Yeah. Sorry to be eating on camera, but...
There's no rules, man. Here.
Big up Billy's calf down the road.
Big up Specs.
I'm trying to get the black card. Yeah, big up Specs as well.
Love Island.
But what are you saying, though? Oh, fuck Love Island as well.
Nah, it's amazing.
You started watching it, innit? I don't know, man.
But I started watching it because on Filthy Fellas, Miles applied for it. So when he came to film, you know how Miles is as well, like an idiot. So when he came to Filthy Fellas one time, he's all dressed up like one of these guys on Love Island. He's like, what do you think? And I was like, this is the worst outfit I've never seen. Because I still didn't want to see it. So he's come there in this jeans jacket. And then the jeans, you know, like the token rips now, the top man rips.
Yeah.
I'm looking at this guy like, bro, what are you doing? Anyway, he didn't get in, but I started watching it because I thought he might get in. What a show. What a fucking show. What a show.
I think they're wet.
Bro, it's like Titanic, man. It has everything. Heartache, despair.
I'd love to watch a show.
Some people.
Call it Bruv Island. Yeah.
Yeah.
Instead of the girls, it's just that Josh Denzel, Wes, and Oliver Jack. Stop calling him that. He's getting too comfortable. Yeah. He's going to end up saying the N-word one day, you know?
No, I'll say that. Close
out. He's already doing the shack. Bollocks, man. But yeah, send them free to Syria and just document it for a week. I just want to talk about today's guest, yeah? I don't know how to approach it, man.
I'll be honest with you. It's just so mad that when you use his name, like if you just take AC and he needs to call off, like African Child, this is a mad thing. Like, I don't understand why we're doing this.
No,
I'm
think...
I'm happy we're doing it, but I don't understand because I'm squared at the same
time. I was a bit in two minds about giving him this platform, but here he is.
No, you weren't. No, you weren't. You.
People, look, I think this is going to be an incredible episode. Mm-hmm. I think it's going to be just weird. I'm just worried he might lash out. We actually got security today. We haven't had security since the Jammer episode. And you know why we needed security for Jammer episode? For Jammer. But people, look, none other than a wonderful African Child, the man who's been on every timeline, every fucking hood page. He's just been taking the UK by storm. I would like to call him the UK's Tekashi 69. But yeah, make some noise. Welcome, bro.
Thank you.
How are you, right?
I'm good. I'm good.
You're dressed in all white, you're looking pure.
I'm trying.
How's life, man?
Life is good.
We've got some Magnums for you as well.
Yeah, Magnum, right?
Sorry, you lot told me you're going to give me some Ciroc.
Yeah, I know. You asked for the Ciroc. Did we get the Ciroc? We're on a budget, bro.
Oh, we're poor, fam.
That's cool, that's cool.
But we'll drink bare Magnums, man.
What's in the bag?
It's my bag, innit? Personal stuff.
What are you saying, man? Let's shake hands. Okay. Welcome. Do you watch Gasworks?
Oh, nice to meet you,
brother. You seen the show? Come closer, man.
Not up until I spoke to you on the DM, and obviously, I managed to go and...
You're looking research and that?
Yeah, search for you guys. I spoke to one of my friends as well.
What'd your friend say? They're crazy, right?
No, my friend Rava said, obviously, he knows you and stuff, so...
Jeez.
Oh, so he said, yeah, he approved it, because obviously, I don't... Like, obviously, right now, the way things stand for me as a person, like, I'm very picky as to what, where to, you know, interviews to do. Is it beneficial to me? Is it, do you understand? Mm. Obviously, after I looked at some of the work that you guys have done previously, I thought, all right, cool, why not? It's a different platform, you know what I mean? So that's why I'm here.
Do you ever get paranoid that anyone might be setting you up or anything?
I don't get paranoid about nothing. If I was paranoid, I wouldn't be here.
I hear that.
I take care of it is.
Yeah.
Real shit.
Well, we're two guys.
How come you're like that? Because you seem like really angry.
It's how I am, innit? Like, it's normal.
But how come?
Like, it's not how come. It's what my journey is, what life has done to me as a person.
And that's what I'm saying to you. That is how come you've got there. That is your journey.
So
exactly.
I never woke up one day saying, I'm going to be aggressive. I'm going to be a violent
person.
No,
I haven't suggested you have. I was wondering why, how did you get to, because I'm not like this. So I've taken a different journey. So I'm thinking, rah, what happens to someone where they get this aggressive to the point where everything I see about you, there's always something negative. I wouldn't want my entry point into someone's life to always be negative, because you know what happens without me even knowing you. I just think you're an idiot. And I don't want to think that about someone I haven't met. It's not fair. So I don't feel like you're giving yourself the best possible example to just like present yourself to the world. It's always something negative. And I'm just like, but why is that?
But who cares? It's my life. I live how I live. Your opinion don't mean nothing to me. I don't care. I don't know you from nowhere. I don't know.
I'm not saying you do.
So whether you approve to what I do or not, I don't care. It's not.
Do you think that's a healthy way of living your life?
It don't matter. It's my life.
I'm not.
Where was you when I done 7 years in jail? Was you there for me? You wasn't there for me. There you go, my bro. So you can't.
So you done 7 years in your life. Is this the appropriate way to live? Then are you happy with this,
bro? I'm a gangster, bro. There you go.
It's not about
you're asking me a question
and you're angry. And I'm saying to you, what?
Bro,
why?
Because it's the way you're coming across. Bro, you're talking wrong. Like, bro, you're talking about, you think I'm an idiot. What does that mean?
That means that I reckon you can put yourself across a much better person than you are. I don't feel like this is a representation of who you are. I feel like you're angry over something. So I'm thinking, what are you angry over? If we solve that, you can start putting yourself in the light of being a better person.
It's not up to you to solve. It's my life, like I said, it's my
100%,
life.
100%, but we all need help, bro. I've needed help before.
I don't want your help.
Fair enough.
I'm good.
Before we get
fair
there.
Enough.
So AC, there's a question we'd like to ask all our special guests, and that question is, are you a bowl cat?
I'm not a bowl cat, eat pussy, I'm not a bowl cat. Straight. I'm not gonna call me a bowl cat. I've moved to, bowl cat, where? I've got eat pussy, innit? We can't call me a bowl cat. Bowl cat, those that eat pussy and hide.
I don't hide.
I tell you straight.
Oh, really?
I don't eat any pussy either.
Yeah. Is there a technique? Like, is there a specific way?
No technique, boy. I just go do my shit. That's it. Do my shit. Gangster shit.
So, I guess I wouldn't really call you an idiot. But I was in two minds about, you know, having you on the show because obviously there's a lot of controversy around your name and like you just send for everyone.
If you really hate me, instead of ratting, tapping bullshit, why don't you meet me in the flesh? Let's meet up in the flesh. Let's meet up, man, like me and Vic did. I'll come and meet you. I'll meet anyone in here, anyone on my Instagram that think that's on crud. I'll meet you today. I've got free day today. I'm not doing nothing today.
I don't think you hold back from speaking your mind, and I like that. I like people, you know, that say how it is. Like, why would you say that you are the way you are? Because obviously you talk about the life situations you've been through. You know, you've been jail, you've done all this, cool. But like, I don't understand. When you talk about these artists and you diss rappers and like, why'd you go for these people? You even diss Maya and Stormzy. You've dissed people like, you going at Young Ads the other day. Young Spray.
Young Ads, bro. Let me address the situation. You know,
yeah.
I want you to understand one, because this is the last interview. I'm not doing the interview after
that's
this.
Fair enough.
Bullshit.
Appreciate
like, I'm just going to
do
what?
Cool. So, I appreciate
do
that.
Do you understand? So basically, the situation with Young Ads, right? I was in France, right? I went to see my family. This guy hit me on a DM, yo, when you can come studio? I said, anytime, innit? I'm in France, when I come back, let's do it.
When was this?
Bro, this was a couple months ago.
Okay.
I'm in France, right? So this guy hit me up. I don't follow them guys. I don't follow nobody. Because a lot of rappers, I do not approve. I don't like this style. They bro, are you nuts? So this guy, you can't tell me something you're going to do, and then, do you understand? So I got angry. I said, yo, brother, what go on? So when I'm hitting him up, so he's talking Chinese. I don't speak Chinese, but I speak English, boy. You told me rate it there, make it rare, innit? Yeah. Understand? So I'm now upset with him, innit? So eventually, I had enough thinking, bro, this guy, they're doing some mad talking. I ain't got a problem with the guy. I ain't got a problem with the guy. He's doing what he's doing. He drinks lean, whatever. I don't do that shit. I eat pussy. I don't care about these people. Do you understand? But you can't. Same thing with Wiley. Wiley done the same thing. I never dickhead. First thing, I probably punch him in his face. Why would you? My mother's life, Wiley hit me up. Yo, when you can come studio? Bam, I come back to England. This pussy was talking Chinese again. Come on, guys, I'm a dickhead. You're playing my emotion. I'm a girl. You can't play with my emotion.
I hear that.
You can't do that to me. So that's why I got onto Wiley. Furthermore, let me finish on this dickhead, yeah? When Drake got onto him, right? Everybody, the whole UK was on Drake's side, right? No rappers in the UK. No rappers. No fucking rappers.
I wasn't. Fuck Drake.
There you go. I'm glad. Right? No rappers in the UK saying rah rah rah. Everyone, team, whatever, do you understand? Sorry, I knew Wiley for a new Jake. I don't know, do you understand? So I gotta keep it real. I'm from the UK, boy. This is my territory, my country, innit?
Mm.
So Drake is from there, innit?
Yeah.
So you can't come here and disrespect people that have worked so hard to create a career for themselves. You're rolling with certain individual, right? You're not feel, oh yeah, cool. Right? No, bro. Do you understand? So by Wiley not responding to me how he did, that's why I dissed him. That's why I dissed him.
So the reason that you're going at Young Ads and Wiley is because they've asked you for studio time and then just
and they never showed
you
up.
What about the Nine situation? What's your beef with them lot?
I don't angle beef with Nine. I don't like him. I don't like
but
him.
But it's the fact that, like, because, you know, a lot of people might not like a lot of people, but it's the fact that you're so vocal about it.
Yeah,
but
I'm Phineas. I'm Phineas with Beers. Beers. See Beers. That's my people.
Yeah. Is that your people?
SK, though? Yeah, Justo. Yeah, Beers. Yeah, I fuck with Beers.
Because Biz
I fuck with Biz.
But Biz doesn't follow you though.
It don't matter. It don't matter if you follow me or not. It don't matter if you follow me or not. Because let me tell you something about this industry, right? Like,
because the way I came in the game and I just dissed everybody, now everyone's scared.
But you did, you didn't.
Everyone's paranoid. Oh, can't be seen to fuck with AC.
But you,
oh,
you didn't diss business. Everyone though. You didn't diss everyone. You're very particular about the people that you choose not to diss. For example,
it's Giggs. Not particular. If yeah. Is that who?
Giggs.
Yeah. What's Giggs done to me?
Yeah, but what has Nines done to you?
He's fake. Yeah, his brother got killed. He never read that. He's gonna give it like turkey. But what's Church
got,
Road.
But what's that got to do?
I'm
with
a rapper.
You?
I'm gonna speak on it.
Yeah. No.
Yeah. I'll speak on it.
But there's other.
I was Tupac than that. Why can't we vocal in the UK? Donald Trump is racist. No one's complaining.
I think a lot of people.
I'm a rapper. I'm a rapper. I'll speak on shit.
I hear you.
There you go.
I hear you.
Gang shit.
Yeah, I hear that. So, I mean, but you just like.
You like what? Like what? I don't rate Nines. I don't rate Nines. So I'm supposed to say, oh yeah, I like Nines. No, I don't rate Nines. I rate Snap Capone. I rate Giggs. I rate fucking Kaiz. I rate battle rappers in the UK. There's certain particular rappers that I do not rate. It's simple.
But there's, I use this show and say, all right, I don't feel this person.
Yeah.
I don't rate this person.
But you're a rapper though.
But. No, but
exactly.
I still have
so
a
so it's not your point to open your mouth, is it?
Yeah.
Because you're not a rapper.
Have to be a rapper.
So your opinion is irrelevant.
No, that's not true.
Oh, of course it is.
Course
I'm coming to
get
as a rapper.
True.
All right, cool. Check
that's
it. Checking it. Checking it.
That's
cool.
Not true at all.
You have critics. Check it. Check it. Check it. Check it. Check it. Check it.
That's definitely not true.
Are you speaking this? You want to speak?
That's not true.
I want to hear your opinion.
Thank you very much. Basically, the music scene is made out of more people than just rappers. So if you rap, you're giving your music to the world. And the reason why everyone can have an opinion is because some people pay for it. So if I pay for something, I can have a fucking opinion. If I pay for this studio, I can say who I want inside here. If I buy that light, that's my fucking light. So if I buy your music, of course I can have an opinion on it. So therefore, you've given an opinion to people that you don't even know because you've put your music in the world. So yeah, he can have an opinion. Go on, man.
You finished?
So what should, I would just like to know why he can't have an opinion. You come to the show, and furthermore, you've come here to have an interview with somebody who can't have an opinion on you. What's the purpose of that?
What was you going to say on the situation?
I said, I wanted to say, fuck Nines, innit? That's what I'm saying.
If you don't rate someone, fair enough. Like, you can have that opinion. But it's the fact that you make it, like, personal about that person.
It is.
You speak about their family members, family members. Like, Russ, for example, you spoke about his dead sister and what you're going to do to her and stuff like that. Like, I would never even want to repeat that on this platform. Like, I think it's just mad disrespectful. So I just want to know, like, why you make things so personal?
Because it's personal. It's personal, isn't it? When you cuss someone, you want to cuss them. You want to hurt them, innit? You want to hurt them. If you're sending for someone, you want to send them. You know, man, don't do subliminals. I'm telling
that.
You, raw. This way it is.
All right, cool. Fair enough.
Don't understand?
You do that.
See me,
yeah.
You see me. What, there you go.
Yeah, cool. Yeah. All right, I hear that. That's right. But what do you want to get out of it? Like, what is your end goal?
It's not my end goal. I'm doing me. I'm going through my journey. Whoever's interested, you follow that journey. If you're not interested, don't follow the journey. It's that simple.
I'll be honest here. When Tekashi 6ix9ine was running around the US, and a lot of people were like, you know, he was dissing everyone. A lot of people were saying, if Tekashi 6ix9ine was ever in the UK, he'll be dead within a week. Yeah? That was the talk. Everyone's like, oh, Tekashi 6ix9ine, he could never flourish in the UK. We can never have someone like that. They'll be dead straight away, finished. I feel that you are probably the closest thing we have to that in the UK. But I think Tekashi 6ix9ine has made money. He's got platinum record selling deal, whatever. He's successful. You, on the other hand, like, you're in the UK and you got 24,000 followers. You've done a couple of interviews. You're on our platform. But I don't, like, do you want to make money from it or what? Like, is this your brand?
Remember, I'm an artist, you know? So what I do is my life, innit?
Yeah.
Do you understand?
Mm-hmm.
What I do behind Instagram, nobody knows. How I make my money, you don't know. You know how much money I got in my account?
No, I don't.
So you can't question me how it was beneficial. Don't do that.
Mm.
Don't do that. If you don't like what, like I said to you, if you don't like what, I don't want people to follow me. It's my life, it's my journey. I'm gonna live how I live. It's that simple. I don't follow you. I don't follow none of you. I don't follow any people. I don't follow nobody because I don't need to. I don't see. Nobody teach me nothing. There's no substance. I know you fuckers. You let people follow. What am I learning? I'm not learning nothing.
I hear that.
I'm gonna follow someone to talk about his watching, bust down, and rare, rare.
Out of curiosity, just for my mind, because I need to always understand things. Otherwise, I just get really frustrated in my head. You're a rapper. So you provide a service for people, but you don't care what nobody thinks. But when you provide a service for people, you need to care what they think so you can make financial gain.
Bro, nobody,
so
how do you buy my music?
So how are you going to make money and be a rapper?
Don't worry about my music. I'm not from here. I'm African. Don't worry about my life. Don't worry about my life, bro.
But how
you're
can
English.
You come?
You're English.
How
I'm African.
How
you're English.
You come,
don't worry.
How can you come to an interview? Don't worry.
You call me here. You call me here. I did not invite myself.
Sure, I did not call you.
Whoever called me, bro. This guy. Bro, this brother.
See what, bro, you know what? I'm just, this is long, innit? I never come to my house for this, innit? I come far.
I
spoke to my people. I didn't want to come. Do you understand? I didn't want to come, but my came in it. But right now, I'm just getting vexed, innit? It's long, innit?
Oh, if I'm a problem being there, Alhan, you can have the conversation. I can go over there, bro. I have no problem. Now, don't get angry.
I ain't got time for this, bro.
Don't get angry, bro. Look, no problem. Here you go. It's not disrespectful. I don't disrespect nobody. Trust me. I don't disrespect nobody. I'm a very respectful person.
You guys know what you're dealing with. You're not dealing with Fredo. It's not Fredo.
Bro, I don't. Listen, I understand. Straight I'm a very boy. Respectful man. You've got two guy. Kids, and I'm not going to be disrespected as well.
Street nigga, boy. Street
Trust
nigga,
me. Alhan, have your interview. I'll stand right here. Do you want no problem.
Yeah, that's fine. That's fine. That's fine.
What's life saying? What's coming up? What projects are you working on? Is it album, EP?
I'm working on my mixtape. Mm. The mixtape's coming out end of this month. It's called So Disrespectful. Got an album, mixtape project. Afrobeat album. So I'm putting out two projects.
Yeah. Sorry about Poe, I think he takes things a bit like.
You're carried away, man. Don't come with that energy with me, my mother's man. Trust me, boy. Don't do that. Do that, man.
Do you want a Magnum or a drink?
I'm saying, man. You're being normal. You're being calm.
Yeah, of course.
Look how the whole thing's changed. Don't do that. I'll go nuts. I'll lose my mind. I'll go about a schizophrenic. I don't want to do that.
I hear you.
I don't want to get nicked. I never come to get nicked, bro.
Do you want a drink or something? Have a Magnum, man. Come closer as well, man. We ain't got Poe in between us to distance ourselves. But like, yeah, I think a lot of people are confused about the AC situation, and I just wanted to know where you see yourself going in the next few years.
Like I said, I'm working on my music. I've got music coming up.
Yeah. Do you not get like genuinely when you wake up? What do you think? Because like you diss everyone and people like you got a lot of enemies.
Yeah, of course.
Which I'm sure it doesn't faze you at all.
No, it don't. What should I? Yeah. We're all gonna die, innit? You're gonna die one day, innit?
Yeah, of course.
There you go.
No one's immortal. There you go. Untouchable.
There you go.
But there's, I don't know. I think you've got a higher percentage of dying earlier than.
Yeah, so be it. Mm. If that's what God wants, it's gonna happen.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What about the situation with Vic Santoro? What happened with that?
The guy's an idiot.
How? What's your version of events?
He's a prick. I went to link him. We made an arrangement to meet. We was meant to meet in Burgess Park in Peckham. And obviously, when I got to Peckham, I took off my, basically I turned my location on, yeah. And I was doing my live, innit, whatever. And then he would have been watching my live, innit, so he saw my live and then he creeped up. Him and someone else, I'm sitting there, bro, I said, what's about to come? Okay, cool. Jumped off and that, and then he's there telling someone, someone like recorded, like film me. I'm like, what do you mean film me? Like, what's this? Like Jeremy Kyle. So from there, I thought, all right, cool, since you're on that, yeah, on a foolishness, I'm not gonna do that, innit? So I jumped in someone's car and I just stayed there. He's trying to come and swing punch and stuff. Nothing happened to me. I never got no stab, I never went to hospital. I went home, I ate my jerk chicken.
But everyone's saying that you jumped in a civilian's car.
Yeah, I did. Yeah. I done that for purpose. Because when you're screaming, oh, film, that's not what I came for. I came to fight you, innit? What do you mean film?
I hear that. But you're someone that like puts everything on camera and you live stream.
Yeah, that's fine.
I'd say
that's
you live stream 50% of your day.
But that's fine. But how can I fight you when you're here there with someone else? I was meant to fight you 1-on-1.
Yeah.
That's the agreement. Because had I known that would have been the case, I could have brought the whole Peckham up. How about that? The whole Peckham would have been there.
I reckon you can take on two guys.
The whole Peckham would have been there. But that's not, listen.
Yeah.
Brother, we made an arrangement to fight, right? It's like Anthony Joshua and Deontay Wilder made an arrangement. All right, cool, we're going to do this and do that, right? And then Deontay Wilder going to link Anthony Joshua. He's there with his people then.
I hear you. Well, but it's...
That's what happened.
You didn't arrange like a...
It wasn't a boxing we were meant match. To meet in the park, Burgess Park. Yeah, that wasn't even played.
If
that
he
wasn't
had
even
sponsors
met.
And stuff, fair enough. But it's a hood fight. There's not really any.
I offered him that. I said, right, let me promote this on Instagram, right? Properly. He said, nah, don't do that.
So he ended up leaving with your bag.
Yeah, because the bag fell on the floor and he nicked it. Run off.
Like him filming the situation and you running into a civilian's car. Yeah. Like a lot of people are now saying that you're the pussy for that.
That's fine. Mm. That's fine.
But
anyone can take an L.
Yeah.
It's how you bounce back from the L. My nigga.
Less is more.
Next question.
What's jail like? You've been jail, innit?
7 years.
Serious?
Yeah, 24 different jails.
24?
Yeah.
Why did you get moved so much?
I'm reckless.
I hear that.
Yeah.
So, you're promoting a fight at the moment with Mr. Montgomery. Is that that's
he doesn't want to fight me, scared. You guys need to get onto him.
He's a skinny guy. Like I watch some of his videos, I see some of his stuff, his content he makes. Like he's he doesn't really look like someone that's gonna fight. I don't think. Like I wouldn't.
No, but he was offering another guy from 6'7", the one with the mask. What's his name?
LD.
There you go. He wanted to fight him. Do you understand? So furthermore, that was my idea, right?
Yeah.
Because remember, I came up with the idea. So right, boom. I wanted to fight Ward Boss. He was the first person I wanted to fight. I wanted to fight Ward Boss. I said, all right, cool. The whole idea behind it was, there's a lot of knife crime, knife epidemic happening in our, like, in our country, and nobody's really doing what real people do. Do you understand? But obviously, I come from an era where if you've got a problem with somebody, you fight. But unfortunately, we live in a time where nobody wants to fight. They find an easy way to stabbing someone. So I said, all right, cool, world boss, I will fight you. He doesn't want to fight me, so that's gone. So but that was what, my what, idea, right?
What,
So that Montgomery, his name is, I can't pronounce his name, Montgomery. He basically trying to come and take that idea to go forward with it.
It's just a boxing match.
That's what I got pissed off. I said, no, all right, cool. If you're going to do that, if you're going to fight a rapper, I must be the first person you fight.
Yeah.
You understand? And obviously from there, he blocked me from Instagram. I can't, you understand? He doesn't want to fight, innit?
But what's the need though? Why? You could just get along with everyone.
No, you can't get along with everyone. It's impossible. It's impossible. Donald Trump and fucking King Gwangun, what his fucking name is, they don't get along.
They do get along.
No, they don't. He's so fake, my guy.
Donald Trump.
That pusher, King Gwangun, he broke the law. He broke the rules. But, he broke the rules because prior to him becoming the president, there was some other like people before him.
Yeah.
And they'll never. You crazy? Donald Trump is the first person to cross over. He should have never done that. You're going to pagan, bro. Come on, boy.
We're saying North Korea's uplock.
Boy, come on, man. Come on, man. It's a joke. Now we got a fucking Boris Johnson, like, next Prime Minister.
Let's talk about, you seem to be quite involved in politics.
I love politics, man.
When we spoke on the phone, you said that's what you wanted to talk about.
I love politics.
Boris Johnson, what do you think of Boris Johnson?
He's a dickhead.
No, rain him.
Straight down. Dickhead.
If you saw him, what would you do? You should do a boxing match with Boris Johnson.
I'll cuss him. Come on, Boris Johnson. Come on, man. You think you fight me? He's a coward. These people are taking the piss out of us. And nobody's talking. No rapper's talking. That's my frustration. Do you understand? We need a fucking general election.
Mm.
And I want to kickstart this shit.
When you go, do you vote?
I've never voted in my life. Mm. I want to get involved in politics. 100%.
Who do you give your vote to?
To nobody. None of these fuckers are suitable to run the country. Yeah. They're ruining the country. They're destroying the country. I love this country more than fucking Boris Johnson. And I wasn't even born here.
Mm.
How do you explain that? I love this country more than the people that was born here. How the fuck do you? Because in order for you to be a good leader, right? In order for you to be a good leader, my friend, you have to love the people.
Yeah.
You have to love everybody that serve the nation.
You could probably run for office. I think you could. You should set up your own party. You could call it DRC UK or whatever.
As long as you guys support me. I mean, I've had police. Unpolice said they'll give me the vote. Mm. So that says something.
Unpolice said they'll give you the vote.
Of course. See how me and you are getting on now?
Yeah.
I wish it was you doing the interview, not my man.
Yeah, it's cool, man.
Because I was about to walk out. Because he's thinking, oh yeah, I'm in a position. Let me ask my man, let me do it. But don't do that. Because you're going to piss me off. Be professional, be normal.
Yeah.
Because on the streets, you will not have to do that. Talk like that on my either. You don't have to do that. So let's be professional. Let's be calm. I never came here with bad energy. I like you as a person. I fuck with you. That's why I'm here.
Thank you.
Understand, brother? So therefore, you must always conduct yourself as a professional, no matter what. If I go to Tesco's, right? And let's say I bought something I wasn't happy with.
Yeah.
Whoever sold me the product, when I go back and complain, the person there can't argue me because I'm a customer, right?
Well,
because customer's always right. Do you understand? Remember, right. I didn't have to come here, but I done it out of love. You look different. I looked at your Insta for real. My mama's different. You understand? Yeah, I like him. You're like, raw, like different, indie type of shit. All right, cool. I wouldn't mind being your friend. Do you understand? Right. So I'm here, like, raw, boom, like, let me go on and get to know this guy, right. And I spoke to my brother Raver. I was like, yeah, chat to poet, right. I said, boom. I came here on a good vibe.
Yeah.
And then he spoiled his shit. But the show must go on, right?
Come on, my bro.
There you go,
the views, I think this will get a lot of views, man. A lot of people have been asking for us to get on. Who's your favourite rapper? Because you got a lot of people
Snap
that you
Capone.
Hate. Oof. Snap Capone.
Snap is hard. Gigs.
He's fresh out.
Gigs. Yeah. Kai's. CS.
CS is sick.
Tiny Boost. It's the aggression. Yeah, it's the aggression. I like the aggression, the anger. And same thing. Obviously, my favourite rapper in the UK is Snap Capone, 100%. I've listened to everybody.
Yeah.
It's like before it was K Coke, but now Snap Capone. It's that hunger. Do you understand? It's that aggression. You know, like I can relate.
But when you see someone like Stormzy, for example, because you sent for Stormzy, not too
I didn't send for Stormzy. On my life, I didn't.
Well, you spoke about Maya.
Maya, yes, he's Mrs.
Yeah, but you know he's obviously going to take offence to that.
No, he's not.
No.
Shout out to Stormzy. That's my bro, man. I love Stormzy, man.
So Stormzy's your bro, but you're dissing his girl.
After I cussed Maya Jama, obviously me and Stormzy spoke, innit? He hit me on the DM, boom, 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 I chat to Stormzy. I'm not going to put my phone out because I'm gay shit. But if you want to show me after the interview, I'll show you after the interview. Normal. Shout out to Stormzy.
So you and Stormzy are friends now?
I ain't got beef with Stormzy.
Okay.
Everyone loves AC. How can you not love AC?
I don't think everyone loves AC.
Everyone loves AC, me, above my enemies.
Well, that's not everyone.
There you go. The non-existent people.
Mm.
I don't see them.
But why can't you just get along with people?
No, you can't. It's impossible, my friend. It's impossible.
What have they done to you?
It's impossible.
Fair enough, Young Ads and Wiley asked you to come shoot them.
Yeah,
cool.
Yeah.
I'll give you that one. Yeah.
Yeah.
But I just think the other shit's unnecessary, fam.
No, really.
You don't need to wild out on all these people. Like, you can just get on with them. Fredo.
Krypton Conan.
I don't even want to say
them. Fredo, Krypton Conan, Nines.
Who these else? Are the people that you're naming. These are the people that you don't get. But why can't you just get along with them?
All these people. Mm. I can't get along with them.
Why?
I can't. People actually think I just cuss people for no reason. Mm. I don't. Every time you hear me mention somebody's name, it's because they've done something. It's either my people or somebody I know. Fredo, for example, right? When Fredo got stabbed, M-Lo get nicked from SK. So how do you understand this? So how can I then not speak on that?
Because it's none of your business.
Of course it's my business. If you're going to give me, you're talking gangster, right? You're talking gangsterism, right? Oh, they're going 100, my one, Hannah. In a German way, but that fucking bullshit comes out of his mouth, right? So you have to keep that energy throughout the whole year. Because you will bump into people. Mm. That's not your fans.
But okay, let me
say. No, check it. No, wait, I'll let you speak, my bro. All right. Listen, right? All the energy that we put to the world, right? Yeah. Whether it's negative or good, right? It comes back. Do you believe that?
Yeah, it's a boomerang.
There you go.
Karma.
Oh, my brother. Yeah, now you understand my language. Yeah. So I am part of this world.
Yeah.
I live in this world, right? So when I hear a fruity rapper like Fredo, right? Talking shit, and I know you're not about this life because I've lived in Harrow Road. When I was living in Harrow Road, Fredo wasn't even born. How about that? I'm from West London originally.
I believe you.
All that whole Harrow Road strip, I used to live there.
Cool.
Westbourne Park, Edge Road, all of that. Woosden, Northwest. I've lived there. West London is my home originally. Do you understand? So for me as a fan of the hip hop, remember, you know, the Americans, they don't really take us serious.
Fuck America. No one cares about it.
No, of course he does.
What?
Of course he does.
We don't need their gratification.
Listen.
Yeah.
From when I know, right, the serious rappers, the serious people in this country, right, that live whatever different type of lifestyle, whether they're low-abiding citizen or whatever they do with the trappers, whatever, ever. From when I know as a citizen in this country that those type of things happen,
yeah,
and they're across the border, wherever they're fucking from, and they're not respecting that, then I have to say something. I have to make you, wow, this really goes on in the UK.
But this comes with a price, and that price is, you know, like, you're talking about when these rappers get caught slipping, they don't do nothing and all this and that. But these times, you know, you got caught by Vic Santoro and jumped in a civilian
But is that caught slipping though? It's not, is it?
I think it is.
It's not because, brother,
listen, you've asked someone to come and buck you at was it Peckham Station? Yeah.
No, it wasn't Peckham Station. It was meant to meet Burgess Park.
Burgess Park. In Peckham. Right, cool. So AC, look, you're on live, giving it the big gun, saying you're going to do this, you're going to do that, you're going to do this, yeah?
Yeah.
Now, obviously, he's come with someone else, yeah?
Why did he though? Huh? Why do you think he came with someone else? No, I can't forget that, bro. Yeah. This way you get technical, right?
Yeah.
Why did he come with somebody else? If you believe you're going to beat me, if you believe you're better than me, right? Yeah. Why are you coming to meet with other people? Bear in mind, we already made an arrangement. That's a sign of fear. That's a sign of mental rod. You know, that like insecure.
But you know what? But what else is a sign of fear is jumping into a civilian's car.
It's not, brother, because... Yeah. I had my boxing gloves in my bag. I was prepared to go bam and just break, spin him around.
But you didn't.
I'm on about this thing. Exactly. But you coming to me, your hand in your pocket. This had his butt. Listen, this has come to me like this, right? He's got his hoodie, right? It's coming like this, right? And some next skinny you, it's like a fucking spaghetti bolognese, right? Skinny. Skinny black you. I could have. So there you there. One,
so why didn't
I could have done the Deontay. It's brother. That's. You don't understand me, bro. All right, cool. So why didn't Vic Santoro fight me in the ring? Where everyone can see, where the whole country can see.
Because it costs money.
You don't. I'll provide it. I'll line it up.
You're gonna pay for a ring.
I'll line it up.
Which stadium?
It don't matter, fam. I'll line it up. I'll stream it. But I'll invest on my mother's life. I will invest. That's one thing I will invest. I want to beat him.
It's
because that belongs to me, which is my Quran, right? Mm. Close to my heart.
Yeah.
He took something personal to me. He took my phone, which had my son. He's got my son's pictures when my baby was born. I'm there washing his first bath. It was me. My son's there naked. So you got all this stuff of mine that belongs to personal. My baby mum said, he see my fucking Insta. Fuck, what's up? What's up? What you doing on my WhatsApp?
I heard that.
Run back the phone, innit? You don't want to run back the phone. Why not? Run back the phone. You showed everyone your bad boy. You took my bag. You stole my bag. All right, cool. Run back my fucking phone. Because that's what the first thing I would have done as a man.
Mm.
There's pictures of my son, my 18-month-old baby. Are you nuts?
Yeah, I would have given that back still. You all right? So has he replied since?
Bro, I wanna see this guy. He's got shows, innit? He's a rapper, innit? He's gonna be going and doing shows and stuff. Let's see how many shows he's gonna do this year, innit?
Because I saw he went on For The Culture, that podcast.
There you go. And you watch his body language, right? Right, was he talking much?
I don't watch it.
There you go.
What was his body
clown. The guy you don't wanna smoke, man. Man already spoke to him, innit? He knows what time it is, man.
I wanna stay here for hours, but we gotta wrap the shop somewhere. My
Absolutely.
Bro, thank you very much for coming on. You're an enigma. I'm still trying to work. I wanted to dive inside your brain and try and make sense of it. I think I'm about like maybe 10% of the way there. But yeah, we'll do a part two.
Follow the journey, follow the journey, man. Let me release some music.
What do you have to promote? What would it do for you to start like giving love and not negative energy? No
I'm more? Giving love. Mm. I'm in the middle of opening a youth center. Nobody knows that. Mm. But I don't have to tell you that. That's my shit.
Of course.
Do you feed the homeless people when you walk past? Do you feed them?
I feed homeless people. I give them
my
money.
Nigga.
Come on, my bro.
Touch me. That's what AC does.
Warm food as well.
That's what AC does. And when I feed them, I don't film them either.
Cool.
You understand? So these are the things that I do behind closed doors. Nobody knows. Yeah. Once that phone is off, nobody knows my life behind closed doors. But yeah, everybody is a judge.
I think you should allow the dead family members and stuff like that.
Cool. That one there, I totally agree with you, 100%. Mm. I agree with you. Many men say, yeah, I've crossed the line. Yeah. And I apologize.
I think you're more smart than you let off.
Absolutely, more than smart.
You know what you're doing.
Absolutely, 100%.
This is big marketing.
100%.
And in 5 years' time, you'll fly out to the Democratic Republic of Congo.
Multi-millionaire.
Maybe.
No, maybe. Will.
Well.
Inshallah.
Thank you very much for coming on, my bro. Thank you. Round of applause for AC, people.